Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Heyman, and this is Jixian, this is Joshua. We are a group of SMU students who are here to we're here today to share a web application that we have built, and we are currently testing against the market. So our company name is MaiMai, where we seek to build trust in consumer-to-consumer transactions. So the agenda for today is very simple. We give you an introduction to our team. We give you a simple marketing video that we actually did. We want to introduce the problem to you and the solution that we have developed in order to address these issues. And last but not least, a live demonstration, a quick one, to show how our application works. So in addition to the three of us, we have three other members who are not here today, and our mentor is Mr. Chuck. So yeah, a quick video. But there is a problem in this market space. Things that there is a lack of security and regulation within a C2C market space. Because primarily, there are a lot of online scams and frauds that happen and they go unrecognized. There's not much things that can be done in order to address it. And even though the current processes that are in place, they take very long and sometimes they can be completely unreasonable. Another thing is that reviews. Everyone looks at reviews as the most important thing before they buy and sell their products. But the problem is, in the current market space, allows people to review each other, and reviews can come in the form where people can give unreasonable reviews due to personal reasons that have nothing to do with the transaction. And as such, you could be someone who's buying, who's selling on a regular basis, but could end up getting negative reviews for no absolute reason or for due to malicious users. And that can have a considerable effect on your business. And overall, this experience causes people to have no sense of assurance when dealing on such marketplaces. So if you take a look at the screen above, these are common things that are happening on platforms like Carousel, for example, where people are playing vigilante, and they're using their own platform, the listing platform, to list and warn people of potential scammers and frauds. In fact, my team and I went down and talked to all these people, where they were, on one day when I searched, literally typing the word scam on Carousel, I had almost 50, 60 listings of people just posting and warning people of each other not to be involved, not to, you know, get into all this. But the problem is, people who try to scam can once again come in with new different accounts and try to cause an issue. Not just platforms, forums, VR Zone, Hardware Zone, and any other local forums, people are buying and selling. And the problem is that on these platforms, usually you don't really have payment options, and sometimes you have to resort to doing bank transfer. And when you're doing this, you are at the pity of the person who's selling you the product. And he or she might just run away with your money. And Similarly, but the problem is these are communities that are very concrete. You want to deal in this community, but then it's very inconvenient, especially if people try to abuse it. Reviews. So as I mentioned previously, the importance of reviews. So reviews can actually play a very pivotal role in determining whether you buy and sell. But then as a seller, I'm not exactly convinced, because what if people give me a rating that does not exactly reflect it, because I've experienced it myself. Whereas I gave a negative review to a potential buyer when I was selling on Carousel, that, you know, you didn't make it on time, I waited an hour for you, you're not really a good buyer at all. But this is not my problem, I'm not the one in the wrong. But this person gave me a negative review saying that I was not understanding. It doesn't make sense. And at the end of the day, it reflects on my profile and people look at it and they think that I might not be a reasonable buyer at all. And based on statistics, 47% of all C2C transactions, that's actually a study done by Canadian University, states that all the reviews that are given are actually not exactly the best or reflective of the transaction itself. And even on eBay, 15% of the top sellers request some of the reviews to be removed because, you know, it's causing a problem to the business. So what is the solution that we have come up with? And that is MiaMia. So there are three main things that we want to bring via MiaMia. First, a platform independent rating. So know that we are not another C2C marketplace. We are a transaction and a dispute management platform where we allow people from other or users from other platforms like forums or any other marketplaces to carry out their transaction process. We are not matching demand and supply of products, but bring their transaction process to us, where we will be able to give them a platform independent rating. What do I mean? So you can have three people, you can have one particular person selling on three different platforms of the same product. So when he or she has customers coming from different platforms, they all consolidate onto our platform because we handle only the transaction. And as such, your rating is not tied down to any other marketplace, but it's a reflection of all other marketplaces, and your review is much more concrete in that sense. Next, a regulatory and mediatory system. So this is one of our unique selling points. We want to be able to develop a dispute management system where we will handle every single component that might possibly arise during the course of a transaction. Thirdly, payment avenues and real-time transactions. So as you can see, we also provide chatting capabilities. And another thing is payment. Payment is very important. Monitor your money. Where does your money go? Who holds your money? And we don't want to blindly bank transfer money to people or do an ATM transfer expecting the person to give you the product. It's not fair for the buyer, neither is it safe as well. So by being able to hold on to the money, we'll be able to protect both the buyer and the seller. So first, most important thing that you want to go via our system is our dispute management system. So if you actually saw the video, and I think the picture's a bit blurred, but you can launch a dispute. For example, product is not as described. Because you're dealing with two random people, there is no regulation involved, and we want to bring that into place. And so using the admin's verdict, which is a third party, which is our administrators, we'll be using the functionalities in our application in order to determine who is the rightful party. So how do we facilitate this dispute management process, you might ask? Who are you to do it? How do you know who's the rightful party? So in order to make our process of solving disputes much more efficient, we introduce online agreements and contracts. So what's so unique about this is that first, most of the things that we discuss on the consumer-to-consumer market space is free text. People just talk themselves. Sometimes you might even overlook the details that you might be, that might be very important to a transaction. Sometimes the seller might say that the screen is cracked at the side, but you might not catch it. And just accept it, you go on the spot, you realize that the screen is cracked, then how? You wasted your time and resources having to dedicate yourself to that particular transaction. So, and this agreements functionality lets the user have an overall look, an overview of the transaction that they are getting themselves in. And we are automatically able to transfer this into an online contract. So all this information will be used as the primary source of evidence when a particular party launches a dispute. As long as you follow whatever that you are agreeing with the other party, you will be safe and sound and be compensated accordingly. So, as mentioned previously, the platform independent review and rating, this rating is not fixed to or tied down to any other platform. It's a reflection of all the customers that you might possibly get from every other platform. And online payment, this facilitates the process of monetary compensation. So you can make a deposit and we will hold the money for you until you are satisfied, the buyer is satisfied. You will then pass over the money to the seller. And sometimes one unique case I want to bring up is that what if I'm a seller and I went all the way down, like one of my members mentioned just now, I went all the way down to the other side of the country only for the guy to not turn up. I wasted so much money traveling there, so much resources and time. How? You can, as a seller, request for the buyer to make a tiny deposit. We will hold on to this deposit. And when you realize that the buyer didn't turn up, you can launch a dispute and you'll be able to compensate you accordingly for the time that you wasted. And of course, where do I have to talk? Your platform is not giving the transaction. Do I have to still use the previous platform to talk to my party? No. You can use our real-time chat features, which is coupled with the agreements. So as you add agreements, you'll be automatically reflected in the chat system, so it provides a more unified process as a whole. So yeah, now let's move on to a live demonstration by my team members who show you how the application actually works.
Hi, okay, so maybe show your hands, how many of you actually dealt with like consumer-to-consumer transactions? Like you buy and sold to any random person. Yeah, okay, some of you here, right? So if you have dealt in that, you actually understand that one big problem now that we have is that it's all based off you say, I say, then who confirm, right? So the whole idea that we have this whole agreements thing that we have tested out with quite a number of people is that we are able to actually formalize the whole agreement part, the whole contracting that my member has been talking a lot about, right? So as mentioned, when we are, our platform is basically to handle the whole transaction part of things. We don't care about how you find your buyer or seller. We just want to know that at this very point in time, we want to make a deal. You deal it through us because we are going to secure your whole transaction, right? So maybe I'll just do it very quickly in the interest of time. So for example, let's say I want to sell something, right? And as a seller, I have a few agreements, right? And because this is the consumer-to-consumer transaction, there are usually things that happen that is very different from something like B2C. For example, if I sell a MacBook, for example, maybe my keys are faded, right? Maybe the backlight of the keyboard isn't strong enough. So these are very unique to this whole transaction that we're talking about consumer-to-consumer. And we provide this agreements thing that basically you can use to ensure that both parties understand what is exactly going on in this transaction, right? So for example, we say, okay, the backlight of the keyboard is not bright, right? Simple as that. Buyer, and we say, okay, we transact through MaiMai, right? Okay, so now we are just going to simulate you a whole transaction flow that usually happen if you have dealt in C2C transactions before, right? So, for example, now we say that the first thing, we say that, okay, as a buyer, my friend here, a buyer, he will have confirmed that I agree that the backlight of the keyboards are not okay. So if he's going to complain about that, then we already have agreed on the very point, right? So for example, if he asks further, like, is maybe the screen, are there scratches on the screen, right? And then I realize, okay, yes, there are actually some scratches, right? So there are minor scratches. And then I want him to agree with me, right? Because this is a formal, like a more like formal contract, right? So I will tell him, right? So I created a new agreement here, and I'd say, okay, if you want to deal with me, you have to agree that I said that, yeah, there are minor scratches on this of the screen, right? Then you basically agree on that, and then we basically have this whole contract thing. right? And the next step to consumer consent transactions, especially in Singapore, is that we usually meet up and deal. And so we have all these kind of more specific agreements, for example, location and time, right? And we can basically set where we want to deal. Right, where this is our school. And then the timing, right? Let's just put it like that first. Right? And then you have to agree. Okay. So the whole idea is that once this whole agreement kind of thing is confirmed by both parties, we then have this whole contract created, like a contract that binds both the buyer and seller, something that isn't happening now in consumer-to-consumer transactions. Right? And if you see what it is basically, before you confirm the whole transaction, you will read through this like semi-contract to say that, yes, I agree that the backlight is not working, there are some scratches, so on and so forth, right? And we plan to deal at this location and at this time, right? Right. So at this very point of time, the whole transaction is created, the contract is basically signed by both parties. So what this actually means is very simple. In the event that there is a problem, a very straightforward problem, for example, if the buyer to say, I don't want to buy from you because there are scratches on the screen, then obviously the buyer is on the wrong side, right? Because he had already agreed that I want to buy this and I agreed that there are going to be scratches on the screen, for example. Right? So this actually helps to aid the whole dispute management process that we actually want to introduce to this whole market now. Right? And of course, if everything goes well, basically they'll confirm and we'll give each other the ratings, right? We basically rate each other. Simple as that. Right, and as like Eamon was saying earlier, we'll have like all our reviews. There will be independent of the platforms that you're gonna sell, you just carry this to your forums, to your different marketplaces, and simple as that, right? So yeah. That's all we have here. If you have any questions, maybe you can just answer them. Yeah, otherwise, thank you.
Any questions for them? I think they're going to get an A. Right, because this is the first few group of students I mentored, the program actually worked. And they actually can take money from their account.
Okay, this is
an
I-spoiling project?
Yes,
this
is
an
I-spoiling
project. So you intend to, like, after you finish,
that's the whole point. Whether we'll check or not, we'll see, we intend to think further beyond a school project.
Yeah. As
good
part,
idea.
As part of your chat function, right, can you share images?
Yes, this is a good point.
Yes, that's quite.
Yeah.
Because then you can photograph
you can see,
the scratches.
Yeah, that's right.
Yes, they can request and we'll just upload. It's just another part of it.
In fact, what happens is that you could put your whole entire listing on Carousel, right, and you just click and the whole thing comes here as well. Yeah, they are uploading into their platform as well.
Yeah. So the idea is that to make it as simple as possible to carry on your listing to our particular platform. Right.
I mean, I definitely see, you know, from a seller perspective, that'd be great, right? What about buyers? Do buyers feel comfortable, you know, having to accept all of these contracts before making the deal or these agreements?
From what I understand so far and from personal experience, yes, it is actually very helpful for both parties, right? Because we really set down the thing. Because
it's my son has gone off and, you know, collected something and it's terrible.
Yeah, we always meet these kind of cases that.
Sorry, so yes. does the buyer have to put a deposit? Because you were saying, you know, so the does the buyer transfer the money in advance of meeting?
In the event that the seller chooses to accept payments only via online payment, then yes, they have to pay first.
Okay, so let's say it's not an online payment, and then they meet up and the you know, for whatever reason,
yes.
Because you know, it's like one party is okay. The seller didn't show up, say.
Yes.
So then the buyer is really fed up. He's tracked half across. How does that compensation happen?
big part of consumer-to-consumer transaction. It's not just the buyer looking at how good the seller is.
Yeah.
The seller looks at how good the buyer is. So that's the unique part of this whole transaction. Yeah. So,
What happens is that if you are a buyer or a seller, you could upload this screen right now, or the link to this screen, to all the Carousel or whatever it is. So they would come back and actually look at your rating before they decide to leave you. Right?
Yeah.
That was the idea.
Yeah.
Right?
And if, let's say, for example, like for a deposit kind of thing, if the seller is a very, very big seller and the buyer is someone new, maybe if you really want to buy an item, like you said, you can put the deposit first, it's perfectly fine, right? So in that case, like cements the interest that I want to buy, and then they can just transact. Right.
How are you guys planning on monetizing?
Currently, it's only through the, if you pay through us, then we take a percentage of the payment. But looking forward, as we if we scale further, we're going to have a lot of transactional data.
Right.
Transactional data can be monetized. Yeah.
So they could actually go to Samsung and say 60% of your base information is as a second-hand sales market in the US.
Just adding on to what you said, right? So if you want any monetary compensation, in a sense, in a way you are inclined to use our payment system. So encourages people for the sake of security and assurance for you to use the system.
Yeah.
And in that case, it helps to facilitate monetization.
So I think the biggest challenge you've got actually are the actual platforms themselves now, because they're trying to solve this problem themselves.
Yeah, they're trying to make it big and sell it to the platform. Each one of them make $1 million.
Yeah, or license.
That's one of the biggest challenges. Right?
Yeah.
Alright, if not, guys, thank you very much. They're still going to be around having pizza, so you guys can catch up with them.